Welcome back, everybody, to the NVIDIA Hearthstone Pro-Am Tournament. Thanks so much for sticking with us. We recognize that the series have been pretty long, so I think some of the players aren't used to the schedules. It's like, oh, well, you're going to be playing at this hour, and it ended like 10 minutes ago. So thank you so much for people who've been hanging out. Our next series is Kalento versus Gaara, a Cloud9 versus Tempestorm. So this one will decide once and for all, Nimsh, who's the better team. This match right here.
Oh,
what
man.
Do you think about that?
Casted by Cloud9 and Tempestorm, players Tempestorm, Cloud9. Best Gaara, best shaman versus Kalento, best priest, I guess, because he was using his priest a lot. Recently, he even won a tournament in France on the back of his priest as well. So I'm really looking forward to this. Like, both players are great, great deck builders. We've just seen Tides of Time and Sixer bringing some new deck ideas with new cards from BRM. I cannot wait to see Gaara and Kalento bringing new stuff, especially from Gaara. Like, he is bringing very interesting ideas. Like, as you mentioned before, a lot of players disagree with Gaara's deck building, but he somehow succeeds with his ideas. So with his greedy decks, I wonder if he's going to show us something different, or is he just going to bring his trusty face hunter and steamroll?
Well, I think he's just going to bring aggro decks. I think that's Gaara's attitude after going to Seed Story Cup 3. He tried playing three control decks that killed aggro, but also killed control. Maybe died to mid-range. That was like his big weakness because he didn't really have a lot of stuff. But he really tried to go that route. And then after Seed Story Cup, he told me, he said, you know what, screw this. I think I'm just going to go aggro decks. Meanwhile, Kalento, he's got Priest in his lineup, which means... he definitely at least favors to have some kind of control. I think he's going to be playing the Warlock deck that we saw him hit number one on Legend with. We'll see the Priest deck, which he's known to open very often in Conquest format. And then the Mage deck, well, I don't know. Maybe it's the Tempo Mage. You think it's Freeze Mage?
It might be Freeze Mage with Torii-san. Like, if you want to counter aggro decks, you might be bringing a lineup that's good versus aggro decks. You know, it's the thing with Conquest. Like, you can target specific types of decks. So, like, you bring three decks that are good versus aggro, and if your opponent is bringing Face Hunter, you put yourself in a good position for the Face Hunter to never win against you. And that might be the case for Kalento and his strategy. We already see that the Mage is, in fact, Freeze Mage, if I'm not mistaken. It seems so, yeah. And Frumgar is a Face Hunter with Leopard Nimsh, so a good opening for him in the beginning.
Well, there you go. There is the Face Hunter and there is the Freeze Mage. So good, solid predictions all around. Now, Kalento, let's see. He's got a way to get some health gain. In fact, I really like keeping Ice Barrier in my hand against Face Hunter because that's how much you need that life gain guaranteed. It's like Healing Touch or an anti-Keel bot in a way. Although, a lot of it can be negated if this is Huffer.
Oh, and this is a Huffer.
That's really problematic.
Oh yeah, Huffer is super strong in this matchup, especially because Kalento doesn't really have a way to deal with it right now. Just playing Mad Scientist to ensure that he'll be able to trade with it next turn, but Huffer dealing 8 points of damage, just being able to attack twice. Even
yikes.
More with Blazuka. Oh my god, so much damage coming from this Huffer. This is like 11 points of damage already from the Huffer, and Kalento dropping down to 17.
Yeah, gosh, he doesn't have any way to actually stabilize beyond just that secret. It's Ice Barrier, though, as we can tell. The Ice Barrier is unplayable, so that means Kalento has 25 effective HP. That is, unless Gaara chooses to mysteriously not hero power, or to not attack this hero power.
It's still very nice play by Gaara, protecting his Huffer, seeing that Huffer was not removed, there was no Frostbolt last turn, so just using the Glaivzuka. And here, well, he attacked before playing minions, so I guess his plan will be to use the hero power. In this matchup, it's really important, well, in any matchup, being a face hunter, you want to use your hero power as much as possible to capitalize on damage and save your cards. Your cards are very valuable, that's the resource you don't have. In the late game, so just you want to use the hero power as much as possible.
It's scary because as the Freeze Mage player, you still don't have many ways to kill off that Huffer. He just drew into that Frostbolt, so as much as Gaara wants to keep putting on pressure with this Huffer, it will get stopped. I like the taking the time to develop the Mad Scientist so that you can get Ice Block up too. That's going to be critical in the event that he needs to survive a little bit longer. And Gaara is just going to build his board up.
Yeah, also he's going to play Explosive Chop. Do you think it's bluffing that it's a Snake Chop? Like, Snake Chop might be troublesome, but then Explosive Chop by itself is not going to do much.
Yeah, it's a really good question. What turn is this? Turn 6? I guess he also wants to be as resilient as he can against AoE. Frost Nova was just used, so this could be a Chain Freeze. Frost Nova into Blizzard into Flame Strike. And he wants to have the most resilient board possible.
Well, still, Kalento has Explosive Sheep, so for Kalento it didn't matter that much if it's Explosive Chop or Snake Chop, because he was able to deal with the snakes. But still, I think Gaara was kind of bluffing the Snake Chop in. Animal Companion giving him Leoc, that's not much. It's not going to do much.
No, but Kalento can play the Ice Barrier. Although, let's see, is he need to right now? It's still something that you might want to evaluate if it's like, can you get away without doing it? Yeah, I guess it's definitely the best time to. The thing about it is, like, Thorazon is going to be, like, almost nothing on this match in this matchup, unless your opponent just whiffs on the turn.
Well, with Thorazon, he will be able to play it next turn if he wants to and kill Leoc, but I think Kalento is kind of safe. Like, even with those minions, just ping Leoc next this turn, play Thorazon, and get some cheaper cards. He still has that Ice Barrier and Ice Block as well, I believe, because there are two secrets. So he is pretty much safe for now.
Ice Barrier technically never has to get activated if Gaara draws direct damage. But he's only got... Oh man, this is really awkward now. He's only got ways to activate Ice Barrier. He has nothing to go through it right now. Every attack will activate that secret. Not to mention that Thorazon makes everything really cheap too.
Oh yeah, especially with Kalento having that Arcane Intellect and drawing 3 cards next turn, getting them cheaper.
Arcane Intellect into Frost Nova, an unnerfed Frost Nova.
Yeah, from the old times. It's so funny because Thorazon is actually unnerfing some cards, unnerfing Sylvanas. Oh, wow.
Wait. Okay, so if he plays Antonitis and Frost Nova, he does 5 damage this turn, and then you'll have 3 fireballs the following turn with 10 damage on board. That's 28 damage if Gaara can't stop it.
And those fireballs would be, 3 fireballs, 18 points of damage. It seems like it's over.
That's not the pop Ice Block. He's got Leroy and Unleash, right? Oh wait, does he have enough space on board?
That would be 4 dogs, yeah. He is like missing one.
Ah, he has too many minions on board! Oh, that's awkward. Okay, so like Leroy and Unleash and Leroy and Hero Power does the exact same thing.
Yeah, but still there is an Ice Block, so it's not really saving Gaara, even though he might actually attack into... Wait. He can't clear.
Right, he can kill off the Antonitis and then...
Oh no, he can clear, I think. Well, he can leave the whelps. If he unleashes now, he can clear Antonitis and Thorazon.
Or damage Thorazon for 1 damage and then push for the rest. Oh, okay. He's playing it really safe because Thorazon doesn't want to make any of those things cheaper. But I mean, by all means, the Pyroblast and Fireball puts him to 6, and then you just have to not die.
Kalando's right. Going to draw cards.
Doesn't really matter at this point. Just have to double Fireball this turn.
Yeah, there is still a possibility of Kazan Mystic. Or is there?
You're right. So Kalento goes for like this super safe play. He's playing around every single possibility. And that's going to wrap up the game. Pyroblast is back for 8 mana.
Unnerfed. Thorison unnerfing cards since BRM release. Whoa.
Sick. Well played. But this is a tough matchup if Freeze Mage gets that early draw and gets that double secret. He effectively worked with 46 health plus the hero power and the AoE was shutting down a lot of those Death Rattle minions, making sure that they were ineffective. And also getting Thorson and Ancinitis was really big, just to me getting multiple turns of reducing that burn. So good stuff from Colenso that game as he takes the 1-0 lead.
Oh man, yeah, I just love Thorson as a card. It's such an interesting design. Also changes the game a bit because unnerfing cards and like changing their cost changes the dynamic of the game after Thorson is getting dropped. So a fantastic card for control decks, and it's really like a great nod to control decks that were too slow to counter aggro. But here with Thorson, if you're able to survive, you're actually enabling yourself with all the cards you have in your hand to stop the aggro decks and steal the win. What Colenso just did. So Colenso won't be able to use his mage anymore. The mage is locked, but Gaara still has the Face Hunter. He has that mage he brought in a Warlock. Well, it might be the anti-aggro setup from Colenso that might be difficult for Gaara to face.
Yeah, the anti-aggro might be strong. I'm worried about that Priest deck from Colenso, because that thing is like trying to... Sometimes it's really effective, like you kill off the aggro with a big giant hammer when you have the appropriate responses with Pyromancer and Light of the Naru combinations with other things. But sometimes you just like you're hitting aggro with a wet noodle because you just don't have the right combination of cards. So that makes me a little scared. At the same time, Gaara didn't exactly draw the best either into making sure he did get the Huffer, but generally speaking, he needed a lot of his direct damage to finish the game and he would be whiffing on some of those draws. So we'll see if maybe that shores up its consistency a little bit as we go into Hunter versus Priest for game two.
Oh man, Priest is in such an awkward, well, not awkward, but interesting position right now with different builds. Like we have this Chinese Priest with Death Lords and Light Bomb. We have the old original Priest. This is a Priest similar to what you played, right, at Seed Story Cup, like Shringmeister, Cabal. Or was your Priest even more different than this?
No, it was actually taken off of Colenso's inspiration because I thought that there would be a lot of aggro at the tournament. And I know Colenso really likes playing this deck because he feels like it's strong against aggro without sacrificing too much. But it looks like his hand is missing a Pyromancer. He has the coin, which is generally nice if you have it. Other than that, he's got very situational cards. He's going to have to wait for a while to be useful.
Well, Gaara got minions that he can play, and it's important to... Well, as a face hunter, obviously, you want a very fast start and to be able to rush Priest. Sometimes you can play it a bit slower, just dealing with minions, keeping your minions on board. I think for Gaara, he's pretty much happy with what he has right now. As long as he's able to stabilize with those minions and keep pushing with damage, he will eventually draw into cards that are important. But Shadow Madness is super strong for Colenso here.
Yeah, clearing the board is so important. And his opponent, Gaara, has Mad Scientist. He's starting to weave in his hero powers already because his hand's looking a little light on the damage side. And he's going to hope that his opponent doesn't have anything else minion-wise because he had to coin for that Shadow Madness. He didn't even have Injured Blade Master or some other combination.
Zek's also playing Arcanine Soul Priest, right?
Usually it does, yeah. Yeah,
Injured
Circle of Healing with Arcanine is just too good to pass up.
Yeah, it's a fantastic board clear. For Gaara, though, like, you know, getting all those small minions and being able to extend the board and deal damage with them is important because there's Quickshot, a new card from BRM, and when you get a Quickshot, you want to have an empty hand. Just cast it and get into another Quickshot, and then cast it and get into Kill Command and deal 9 points of damage out of nowhere.
That is a desperation thought steal, just because he didn't really have anything to do on turn 5. Haunted Creeper is reasonable against aggro.
Oh, yeah.
Particularly against that Leper Gnome, but it's another thing where you're investing your boards and you're still taking damage upwards to 8 next turn, as opposed to simply using the Light of the Naru or something else.
I really wonder what kind of trap it is. Is Gaara playing explosive and snake trap? Like, that's one of the most standard builds right now. One explosive, one snake trap. For the tournaments. Like, for ladder, it might be a bit different. But for the tournaments, we've seen snake trap being super powerful recently.
Yeah, it's such a strong mix-up. You can't always predict it correctly. Like, even if your opponent slams Knife Juggler, it still very well could be Explosive Trap. So there's no guarantee.
Alright, Gaara's going all in here. No respect for AoE, or rather, like, hope that AoE is not there. That's one of the risks that Hunter has to take. Sometimes you just need to go all in and hope that there is no answer to your cards, and if there is no answer, then you just win right there. Shadow Madness, top deck.
The scary thing again is what trap that is. If it's Snake Trap, it's problematic, but if it's Explosive Trap, this trades really easily into the Knife Juggler. And it does. So Kalento could still climb back.
Oh yeah, 16 points of health. Animal Companion is a nice card to get.
That can be so nasty.
And it's not nasty at all.
It's mildly nasty. It's a little gross.
Drops to 7.
It's fine. Oh, Wild Pyromancer comes. Is it too late? If he Pyromancers and then Naru, and then
Circle
of Healing. I guess it gets too complicated if he does that. He'd rather just use this now and just try to disarm your opponent. You just can't deal that Leok very efficiently.
Well, only Leroy was killing him. Or like quick shot into something. Like, it's 6 points of damage is difficult to deal. Alright, so Kalento drops to 3. And he has that hero power that counters Hunter's hero power, but then there is the weapon, no taunts. Is he going to go for Animal Companion Misha to be able to do something? He might have to. This is really dire for Kalento right now.
Yeah, he needs to heal him. He needs something, because he's just going to die without
his Misha.
Right. This is his one opportunity to live.
And he gets it.
Oh, he gets Misha. Oh, whoa, man. But, you know, now he has to heal up and not attack. And yeah, one thing that's problematic is that,
Oh, wow, you come out on deck, Gaara.
I thought it was
I mean, it's hardly a top deck because Hunter really has all of the tools that are needed. And just a simple Wolf Rider or Quick Shot. So Gaara had all the things. Like, he pulled Kalento there at a spot where a single card dealing damage would be enough.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, even if he stabilized that turn for on board, it's just like he doesn't have enough health because he'll always be within one kill command finish. That deck generally doesn't heal very much at one time. It heals over time. And if you just cancel out 2 for 2 every single time, it's just going to be like a quick shot to win, or like you said, Wolf Rider to win, Arcane Golem to win. And that's like too hard. And not to mention that you can't pressure too much on the other end without Power Word Shield. Because if you got Power Word Shield, then you can use Circle of Healing and have Light Warden do an insane amount of damage. But yeah, you have to make sure that your opponent's not going to kill you on the backswing, too. So it's very, very, very hard.
All right, so Gaara took the game with Hunter. Right now it's 1-1. Kalento's Priest has to win versus Mage or Warlock. And then both players, they do have the Warlock. I wonder what kind of Mage, Gaara, bro. Do you think, like you said, those are aggro decks. Do you think this is Mech Mage?
Yeah, I'm leaning towards Mech Mage for Gaara, just because I think it's more consistent with what he was talking about. He could have easily just flipped it around and just wanted to play Tempo Mage or something else. Which would surprise me a little bit, because I feel like Gaara would rather be a little bit more on the aggressive side if he was playing mage. No, he's playing freeze mage.
Alright.
Because I was telling you, man, at Seasword Cup, he was like, man, I'm just going to play three aggro decks. Screw it. But I guess he mixes it up.
Well, seems like a misclick. Maybe he named it like, you know, wanted to play a deck with Snow Chugger, so he wanted to have freezes, and then he takes freeze mage. No, but honestly, Gargara can definitely play freeze mage, and that's a very good deck for Conquest as well. It's really hard to target. But Kalento is bringing the... Demon Lock, I guess, with Void Colors. We've seen different Argus there. So it might be the aggressive Demon Lock.
Yeah, the Void Terrors and the Nurubian Egg is going to work really well. Although, sometimes you can make a case that the Egg doesn't necessarily always want to get popped because it's disincentive against AoE, but I think if you start off this quick, like turn 2 Egg, turn 3, 4, 4, and 3, 5, it's just too much.
Yeah, also he has the Void Caller on 4 and a Doom Guard. From the Void Caller, he even has the Silence for Freezes or a Doomsayer on the opposing side.
This would be an interesting point, game. Too. Maybe he draws into something better on turn 3, Imp Gang Boss, and then he saves the Void Caller for like the ultimate Wombo combo. Nah, he didn't draw it, so go for the tempo play.
Yeah, 3-5 and a 4-4. Even against this Acolyte of Pain, just drawing two cards or one. I think Gara can still... Once you ping the Acolyte? If you ping the Acolyte, you're drawing one more card.
Yeah, but I think Arcane Intellect becomes harder to play over time. Not to mention his opponent might just ignore Acolyte. And just go face. Board.
Look at this board. How do you deal with it? Well, Doomsayer is one of the ways, but you still need to freeze it somehow. And there's no Nova and no mana for that as well.
Yeah, he realistically might Fireball. I guess Frostbolt stalls too.
It's very difficult for Gara, I think, especially because of the Iron Beagle in Kalento's hand. Like, even if Gara tries to kill it with Doomsayer, do you just play Doomsayer here to soak some damage? I don't think you do. Maybe... Won't Gara overdraw?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5... He's got 9.
Because I was thinking Loot Hoarder, maybe. Then you go to 8, and you draw to 9, to 10. You know, just to get that Frost Nova, and be able to Frost Nova Doomsayer next turn.
Yeah, Mad Scientist does give him a draw and a play, because it puts out 3 more mana, and it reduces the chance for him to draw an actual secret.
Yeah, that's a valid point of thing, as well. Right now, I think Gara has 10 cards, actually.
I think he still has 9. Last card left.
There's one more, I think. Yeah, there was a Frostbolt in left as well.
Oh, good call. It was tucked in. Right. Yeah, in that scenario, then you definitely don't want to play Loot Hoarder.
Alright, so Kalento can just push here easily. Mad Scientist is not doing that much. Just getting that Void Caller that will be able to summon Doomguard if dealt with. Really strong Defrattle card in the situation, also pushing the damage. So right now with no... Alright, so is Gara dead? Like, he can't cast Blizzard. And Frostbolt, he has double Frostbolt, he has Ice Lance. Now he got Ice Barrier.
Yeah, this just stinks. Ice Barrier, it gives him the opportunity to develop the Doomsayer and try to freeze, but this is just a Hail Mary attempt. And he knows it's pretty easy for his opponent to kill with just damage on board, like Abusive Sergeant. Or in this case, the Owl.
Yeah, right now the Owl is super powerful. But then Gara will be able to gain time. Next turn, he will be able to Blizzard, and then he has another Blizzard, and then in time, maybe that Doomsayer will actually work.
Yeah, I guess so. Iron Beak Owl comes here, and that That keeps Kalento's board alive, which means his Doomguard can come down the following turn and potentially pressure for the kill. Or, sorry, not the kill, but the Ice Block pop. Assuming Gara gets something to complement with it. Second Ice Dance is not that helpful here. He's going to have the Blizzard.
Yeah, Blizzard is definitely good here. It creates two Spectral Spiders, and with the Doomguard, Kalento will be able to deal 7, but that's not enough to kill Gara, even though there's no Ice Block. But I'm sure he's concerned. He has 13 right now, so something like a Power Overwhelming on top of Doomguard. It's like 11, really close. Oh, Sea Giant from Kalento.
Mm-hmm. Sea Giant, really problematic. You can't deal with high health minions easily as a Freeze Mage. Just because there's so much limited, well, not limited, but you only have specific burn as your removal. And you, even then, they don't really reach the 8 health range. 7 because of fireball ping, but not 8.
Kalento is already going for Power Overwhelming here. Alright, so Gara will have to Blizzard this. But the problem is, he's not drawing many cards, so he's not getting closer to a kill setup. Right now he's just struggling to survive. Also, yeah. A Blizzard will activate the Voidcaller, giving Kalento a free Doomguard.
Ooh, that's a good point. The Voidcaller is going to yank that thing out, and it's going to be way too hard. The problem is the sequencing, too. If you Blizzard in first, he's going to come out of there, and then you might be forced to Ice Lance just to make sure not to die.
Oh man, you know what's the funnest thing? Doomguard comes out, and then Kalento can just play Juggler and Implosion, and two knives going for face might end up the game.
Well, I assume he's going to have to Ice Lance this Doomguard because he has 7 health. There's just too many ways to buff it.
Yeah,
he did use Power Overwhelming, but I don't know.
But then your next turn is super weak, right?
Yeah, that's a good point. Unless he picks up Frost Nova. Two explosions.
Alright, Kalento taps. He can tap now. He is in a good spot. Chocolate double implosion. Oh my god.
It's pretty funny.
Can he double? No, he doesn't have enough mana for there. Interesting. This is a really fun game to watch.
Oh, it rolls for 4. Only 3 can come out, though. And reasonable juggles to the Doomsayer, not going to the Fates.
Wow. Gara has no freezes. He only has the Frostbolt. And I think he has to do a Force and Play, kind of. Like, play Root Hoarder, maybe. Ping it. That's 4 mana. But then again, he's just playing not to lose here. With Ice Block, I guess he can buy himself a turn with Ice Block and try drawing some cards with Thalnos and with Hoarder. He's really desperate to draw the board swipes.
Yeah, I don't really think of a way for him to really get out of this one easily. There's second Doomguard, which means there's damage from the hand now. Even if he gets Alexstrasza, how does Gara stabilize, right?
Yeah, he needs to clear the board and then heal. Or maybe like clear the board instead of an ice block.
Oh, there it is. Nice block. Second ice block.
Oh, ice barrier is actually good. But then the implosion was an ice block.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Knife juggler is too big of a deal. He doesn't have to play Doomguard.
He's a Frost Nova, and he doesn't get it. Oh my god. Seems like he never got those Frost Novas.
That's right, so Gara passes over, and Kalento is up 2-1 over Gara, so that means Gara is going to be down to 1 life left. Kalento just has to win with Priest. Priest against Freeze Mage. Well, the fact that you don't have too many heals is great, that you can stall out their board, which is nice, as the Freeze Mage. But then Gara has that Warlock deck himself, which I know that Gara really liked Handlock in the past, but I'm not going to predict that anymore at this point. I don't know what he's going to play.
Yeah,
maybe he's really gonna possible. Play Zood like he did in DreamHack.
It's possible. I mean, Gaara is a guy who can play any type of deck. So this, and we have so many archetypes for Warlock now. We have the Handlog. We have the Handlog with Demons. We have Demon Lock, which is defensive, offensive. We have Zoo. We have new Warlocks that are coming. We have OTK Warlocks. So it can be a new Gaara Warlock that we haven't seen. So a lot, lots of possibilities. But Freeze Mage versus Priest, that would be an interesting matchup as well. Like a single Thought Steal, getting an Ice Block for Kalento might change things. There are many ways. Like that's a very interesting matchup to watch, actually. And a very difficult one for the Mage player, I believe.
Yeah, yeah, it depends. I guess the draws really will dictate a lot of the things, too. So too early to tell, but Kalento is one game away from redeeming himself from last week. Last week, 6-0 promptly defeated Kalento. I want to say 3-0. This is while you were traveling to see Story Cup, Nimsh.
I actually haven't seen that, unfortunately, so I'm not sure about the score. But then Kalento is in a very good position to take this match, and I think our players are ready, so we can quickly jump into the game.
All right, Mage versus the Priest, game four, coming up and seeing if Gaara can shut down the Priest. But if the Priest gets off to a great start, let's say Circle of Healing with the injured Blade Master, you're just taking 4 damage a turn no matter what.
I'm just like trying to...
All right, so Shrinkmeister on turn two, just to put on some reasonable pressure. It's like we talked about, though, this matchup can still be really tough to win from the Priest perspective. You don't get to build a board early. Thought Steals, maybe it could help. I'm trying to think. I guess Antonitis would be really nice if you Thought Stole it.
Yeah, like Ice Block Antonitis. Not sure about Alexstrasza, but it's some healing, and I think, like, how do you think the new cards change the matchup, like Torii-sun or Light of the Naru? That's some
Resurrect. Is that what you're talking about, the new cards?
Well, maybe Resurrect might be useful, I guess.
It's just too situational. You could easily get a 1-2 or if nothing died that game. Like, you can get nothing, which really stinks.
So who's the beatdown in this match? Is it Priest? Like, Priest has to be the one playing minions and attacking Freeze Mage? Or can Priest just chill and try to get cards, you know, to counter the Mage?
Yeah, I would have to imagine the Priest is the beatdown player because you're putting on the pressure. Although, maybe sometimes... No, I would say Priest is generally the beatdown player. It, like, there's, you know, rules are definitely, like, breakable in Hearthstone. Like, sometimes the laws and rules of what you come to expect don't exactly come to pass. Like, in this scenario, usually you want to take a lot less damage, but Gaara chooses to hold on to his Frostbolts here.
So the Thought Steal, I believe, was Mad Scientist and Acolyte of Pain. Not really exciting for Kalento.
No, those are actually quite bad. The Mad Scientists don't do anything. I suppose it does allow him to put out minions, but he could do the same thing with Arcanine Soul Priest. The problem is Arcanine Soul Priest denies from healing, and healing yourself or your minions are often better than just attacking the face for a little bit more.
Acolyte of Pain might be useful to draw cards. Because right now, Kalento's hand is not exciting with just Arcanine Soul Priest. That is not... whoa, there is a Kabal Shadow Priest into that Loot Hoarder.
Yeah, Kabal Shadow Priest would be great to steal it. Just, if you deny card draw from Freeze Mage, they stall out very quickly, too. It's part of what makes the deck so consistent. The fact that you have Mad Scientist, Arcane Intellects, Loot Hoarder, Acolyte of Pains... Like, a third of your deck is dedicated to drawing.
Yeah, also, Mad Scientist is so good because it is filtering your deck. So not only you draw a lot of cards, you ensure that the quality of the draws is bigger because the secrets are getting... they're being filtered from your deck for free. So Kalento getting the beatdown roll, having a full board of minions, trying to rush the Freeze Mage just to beat him down.
Well, the Blizzard is a really important draw, just so that he allows him to save Frost Nova for if he wants to do something else on the later turn. The most important thing is, can he set down Ice Block and before he drops Alexstrasza, can he Alexstrasza safely? And if so, does he have the ability to burn his opponent in follow-up plays? Because it's not just important that you have Ice Block and Alex, but the fact that you can kill your opponent.
Oh yeah, definitely. But this is the thing to do as a freeze mage, just those three steps. That's why you have to draw a lot of cards, because you need to get all the combo pieces. Well, Colento just continuing doing damage, even with the heals. So do you Flame Strike here? Does it do anything?
I mean, it reduces the power of board to 4. Yeah, I wouldn't mind Flame Strike here.
I think you can also Blizzard.
Huh, what about Frost Nova?
What about Blizzard and Icelands into Arcanine Soul Priest? Where I don't think that's the play because Agara needs the burst. But then again, like, how afraid are you of Arcanine Soul Priest doing damage to you with spells like Light of the Naru and a Hero Power? You shouldn't be that afraid, I feel.
Yeah, I guess the alternative. I don't really like any alternative. Developing something on the board like Thanos seems like it's too easily exploitable. The nice thing is that you can't get it stolen by Cabal Shadow Priest unless your opponent gives up a minion on board.
What Gaara needs, maybe, that's the question. He has the ice. Is there an ice book in his hand? Not really. So he needs an ice block, he needs Alexstrasza. And with regards to the burst, he doesn't have that much burst himself as well. He only has that Frostbolt and Ice Lance. Gaara needs time.
If I'm Kalento, I feel like I never want to play Sylvanas, by the way. Just too easy to force, to allow your opponent to force a Doomsayer play. Wow, Opsta just keep on using these Power Word shields and churn on through. Shrinkmeister, gonna have to sit this one out. You can still do damage with the Hero Power. It's just like the Hunter Hero Power. Just not, it doesn't last forever.
Oh, there is a Doomsayer pickup, so he can clear the board. And
that's
how much mana is that? Yeah, even draw cards with Arcane Intellect if he wants to. Blizzard.
Yeah, Frost Nova is more versatile. In fact, sometimes you want to keep this Arcanine on board sometimes. Not necessarily in this moment, but that means Priest can't heal. So if you Alexstrasza them down and you have the appropriate burn, sometimes you win.
Oh yeah, certainly. Also, like, Blizzard was a bit clunky. So it's not like you can do a lot when you cast Blizzard because it costs 6 mana. So casting Blizzard now gives you more flexibility with that Frost Nova and Arcane Intellect if you want to draw into cards. Because it's like Gaara had a lot of cards that are not that useful, and he had those Arcane Intellects to draw into the cards he actually needs to win the game. That's why using the useless cards was right. Dropping to 12 seems dangerous, but it's a priest. Like, priest is not known for burst.
I mean, that's what you think. But actually, you're pretty much right on this scenario. There is enough damage on Gaara's end with Thanos to kill. So Colento needs to Shadow Word Death that and Light of the Naru would heal himself up to 20. That gives him 4 mana remaining and allows him to play the Shrinkmeister or the Northshire Cleric. Is there a better play?
Not sure. I'm just trying to count damage in Gaara's hand. That's 16, right? Does he have mana for everything? It's 4, 5, 9.
Yeah,
yeah.
Mana for that. With one more Ice Lance, in fact.
Well, so if he gets an Ice Lance, that's it. Because then he will have 21 points of damage.
Mm-hmm. Ice Block is not it, but it's somewhat nice to have just so that you have the possibility of killing your opponent next turn. I'm not sure if he wants to go fishing for Ice Lance, though. If he plays...
I'm not really sure if he should burst now. Maybe he should start with Arcane Intellect, see what he gets, and and then decide if he wants to just Ice Block, maybe Fireball if he gets more burst.
Right, if he draws another Fireball.
Yeah. You have to assess at this point, like, how much damage can Priest heal against you? You've seen the Thought Steal cards, because Mad Scientist and Acolyte were kind of clear.
All right, I like the Arcane Intellect play that you mentioned. Let's draw into that Ice Lance. Here we go.
Oh, Frostbolt. Frostbolt is important as well.
Yeah, it's pretty much helps. He should also ping the face. Oh, does that... Wait. Does he get the same damage because he has coin?
I think he can cast everything. Wait, that's 8. That's 11 points of mana to cast everything.
Right, just because he had Thanos, he could Frostbolt, Ice Lance, Fireball, and do that with the coin.
So that's 4, 7, 9, 16 points of damage with Thanos.
Oh man!
And now he has to protect himself as well, so might have to cast a Blizzard. And Colento is actually escaping Gaara's grasp.
Yeah, this is really tough all of a sudden, because that Light of the Naru being super clutch. Gaara has to dig for more stuff. He can get Fireball and Ice Block. Ice Block times 2.
Malygoth. Whoa.
Oh, I love it.
This is the Gaara card. Seriously. I love it as well. Well, but now Gaara has to think how to survive.
He doesn't have the Emperor. The Emperor with Malygoth is super cool, because now Frostbolt Ice Lance becomes insane damage. If he gets 2 Ice Lances, it's like 26. It doesn't matter how much Priest actually gets, but he's used his last board freeze, I think.
Oh, man. I just love the new meta game. It's so cool. Like, seeing Malygoth in Freeze Mage and Druid, seeing those new cards from BRM, I tell you, like, a couple of weeks the BRM finishes, we have a whole new meta game with greedy decks, and it's perfect. Especially with Conquest, where you don't have to be that afraid of the aggro decks, because people will mix them.
I love Malygoth over Pyroblast, because Antaeus comes down. I love it over Pyroblast because of the implications that you can do. Wow, Thorazin's a really big draw. He plays that in Ice Block. That's like I think that's game.
Is Malygoth that game? Drops down to. Well, he can play Malygoth and Ice Block next turn. I'm not sure, actually.
No, he can play Malygoth and then... Fireball still costs 3. I thought he could Malygoth coin and then play everything.
Oh, no,
but he's going to still be 1 more mana. So he needs to pick up Ice Lance number 2, I think, and that's game.
Well, right now, Colento is the one getting the Fireballs, and he's going to pop the block, right? Yeah,
He can pop the block easily. It's all about making sure to do it correctly. Does he want to...
I think you Fireball face. Wait, he needs 12. Hmm. Because he
also should heal himself.
Well. You want to do a lot of things here.
Yeah, so just Fireball the
Emperor. Antonidas can attack, so it's all good.
You just want to make sure to sequence everything, so then you can also heal yourself, too. That's the big important thing. Just keep putting yourself up to 21.
Well, he can just attack with Antonidas, then Fireball phase, then pop the block with the Northshire, then Fireball the Thorazin, and then still heal yourself if you want to. Or even cast the Nova. So attack the 5-5 with 4-5. Oh, no, that will not be enough mana. So I guess, like, you double Fireball and Hero Power.
Right, okay. Yep, exactly. Got it. He needs that Ice Lance. Ice Barrier, that's not it. So he needs to play the second Ice Block. He just plays the second Ice Block and Fireball. And now it's like... Wait. How much is that?
How much is their next turn? Yeah.
Frostbolt, Fireball is...
I think it's plus 5, right?
Yeah, so it's 8 plus 9.
7 plus 10.
So 17.
18.
So it's 17 damage. Yeah. So. Yeah. Okay. So because he had that like that Maligos, it was like really really powerful. He's gonna fireball the the Thanos and heal himself. But that, I'm telling you, man, this Maligos is so good.
I think it's like, it's game actually because Gaara with Maligos can deal what like 3 plus 4, 7, 17.
Yeah, there it is. There it is. This is a 26. This is a 26 damage combo.
Whoa, this is actually sick.
I brought this deck to Seed Story Cup, man, because I wanted to destroy people with it.
You played the Maligos Priest Mage?
Yeah.
Whoa, I haven't seen it. Congrats. It's a great deck. I love it.
It's really, really good in the mirror. Like, you know how Freeze Mage has a problem dealing with Ragnaros on the board? Can you imagine how they deal with the Maligos? They can't kill it even. It's like just as problematic.
Yeah.
And in the Freeze Mage mirror, it's like you go through ice barrier is the biggest problem. So you drop Maligos and then you just like fireball them and then you win. So I brought it because I thought people would ban Warrior and you would bring Maligos to try and win the mirror. And it also is like much better against Druid than Pyroblast because you often don't get the chance to Pyroblast Druid. But if you can Alexstrasza and then combo them for like 26 damage, it's really, really, really good. Druid can't fight back. Man.
I'm so happy because like in the beginning of the series today, we talked about that we want to see more dragons and we see Maligos. Also, Issera is back in Warriors, so I'm super hyped for the post-BRM metagame. Also, when we get all those dragon cards and we'll be able to play Maligos, Issera, Alexstrasza, maybe even Deathwing at some point. That would be so cool.
Yeah, so really good stuff. Really good stuff coming out from the Maligos Freeze Mage, and it's done. So Maligos ends up being the reason Gaara can finish. That second Ice Block draw was really big, too, so that way he could get time. But it was just so much damage. Like, you saw that Gaara would have Kalento killed, like, twice over. He had, like, 31 damage and like in burn just like over a course of two turns, so there's no way he could be able to survive that. Really cool stuff.
Oh yeah.
So now we go into game five and it's gonna be Warlock versus Priest. And I feel like Kalento is gonna be at a pretty strong advantage just because Priest is one of the best classes at dissecting Warlock. Unless it's a handlock with a bunch of giants and Twilight Drakes.
Yeah, then if it's a handlock, handlock is definitely favored. So yeah, now it really depends like what kind of warlock deck Gaara is bringing, and this will decide if Gaara is favored or if Kalento is favored to win the whole match. But great match overall. Like I really enjoy this series, and the last game to decide who is going to win.
Absolutely. So I guess we're just gonna wait for it to start. I'm going to be looking at if Gaara has played Zoo, he has to make sure his opponent doesn't draw circle combos. If he's playing Handlock, then he's in a pretty good spot. I'd be surprised, though. I feel like all the rage is around Imp Gang boss, and Priest is one of the best classes at dealing with it by taking it with Cabal Shadow Priest.
Yeah.
So I don't really foresee the Warlock generally doing well against it. The problems can be through Nerubian Eggs and activating it early with Void Terrors and just punishing them with four attack minions, just like the good old days.
You know, the thing with Priest is that, I think you mentioned it before as well, like Priest sometimes doesn't draw the cards that he needs. Even though you have a lot of answers, you need to get the answers at the right time. And sometimes Warlock can just snowball as well. As you said, like Nerubian Egg into Void Terror, being a 4-4, really hard to deal with, even though there are those Shrink Meisters, but you do have to draw into them. You need to get the Shrink Meister, you need to get the Shadow Madness, and then Cabals. Like, if you are stuck with Light of Nauru or like Circle of Healing without Arcanized Soul Priest, you are just getting overrun. But more or less, I think it's a good matchup for the Priest, because most of the time he does get some of those answers, and he has so many to deal with aggro decks. But then, if Gaara is bringing Handlock, the game will be so much different because then it will depend on Shadow War Death, on Thought Steal, and it will be a very hard matchup for Kalento.
All right, cool. Well, that's going to be the last game of the series coming up. The Priest versus this Warlock. Really cool stuff. This is the last day, too, I think. It's Wednesday, correct? It's the last day before the next wing starts releasing for Black Rock Mountain. I know tomorrow it comes out for America, probably around 24 hours from now. I'm not exactly sure. But that should involve the next wing, which is good stuff. I think Paladin's going to get a nice little buff there with the Dragon Consort. Does Cro-Magnus come out next week?
I'm not entirely sure what we're getting tomorrow. But whatever we get, the ladder will change again. And what do you think about the thing that we're getting those cards released? Oh, actually, I think our players are ready. So we'll jump to the game in a moment to see Priest versus Warlock, Kalento, Cloud Knight Kalento versus Temple Storm Gaara.
All right. Well, looks like we're just having a little bit of an issue, so we're just going to get settled as soon as possible. But let's take this opportunity to talk about the NVIDIA Tournament Nimsh, about like what it is, because some people might be tuning in. They don't really recognize what it is. They just heard that Kalento and Gaara is playing, so... Let's explain a little bit of the format. Like how far are we, and what are we playing for here?
All right, so this is week four of the whole tournament. We have this is the Pro-Am tournament. So we have the part where the pro players are playing. We have 16 people, I believe, 16 pro players selected and invited to play in this tournament. They play against each other. And in the end, they will be matched versus 16 people from the open qualifiers. So the top 32 will be played at some point by the end of May, I believe. 16 pro players versus 16 amateur players. And for the amateur league, we had 15,000 players signing up across all the regions. And those matches are being played all the time throughout the weeks. And so many people playing Swiss tournament. And it's also cool that it's a Swiss. It's not a single elimination. Just come in, you lose, and you're out. It's a Swiss, so you can play many rounds. As long as you're willing to play, you continue playing, getting those opponents, and you can practice against them and advance. If you advance to top 32, you'll be matched versus the pro players, and we'll have a great tournament. Frona, what's the prize pool overall? Because we do have the World Championship points, and we do have a prize pool for the finals.
It's $25,000, I believe, which is the threshold to make it a premier event with World Championship points on the line. So, cool stuff. Lots of good things. Because we had a little bit of issues, guys, we're going to be jumping in mid-game so you guys get a good sense of what's going on here. So, thanks for that awesome overlook, Nimsh. Again, the score is 2-2, and looks like we've missed a little bit of action, but... generally speaking, get this right idea. Kalento got the board early, and now Gaara is trying to fight back for it with this knife juggler, but he ended up having a trade into the Northshire Cleric, and that's not ideal at all. But the big thing that you have to deny Priest from doing is drawing cards, so that's completely understandable.
Oh man, for now we can see that Gaara is actually bringing the zoo. So there is the gang boss, there is the direwolf alpha. We've seen knife juggler getting killed. But on the other hand, Kalento has a pretty good hand with Shadow Madness, Belcher, fantastic curve actually. Shadow Madness into Belcher into Kabal Shadow Priest. So right now Kalento making this trade, it's really important. But then Shadow Madness will be able to deal with two minions at the same time. And then Kalento will just start packing the stones. The second Sludge Belcher is huge as well.
Yeah, the Sludge Belchers back-to-back might be a little bit too much, but there's always good old Implosion, and you might not think of it, but Defender of Argus might be really big for keeping on the pressure and putting on a reasonable amount of power on board, because even though it's just a 2-3, it's still 9 stats that gets distributed onto the board here. So Implosion's going to be pretty big.
Oh yeah, Implosion is the thing here. Like, if Implosion hits, then Gaara gets an immense advantage. And also we can see that Kalento doesn't have any AoE cards in his hand. No Holy Nova. No 3 points of damage is a lot. It's more than average, I guess.
Yeah, it's exactly average. So.
Alright.
Yeah.
2.5 is an average, I guess. Change your
mind. Stealing the with the Cabal is definitely good, but Gaara did dodge a bullet by making sure they didn't steal the Imp Gang boss, because that would be problematic too.
So what do you do now, being Gaara? How important it is to trade with the board or going for face? I think you need to just trade as much as possible because you do have the board extension with the gang bosses. So you're more willing to trade and set up a board. Also, still no AoE for Kalento.
Yeah, you definitely want to kill out the Cabal Shadow Priest because it one-shots the Imp Gang boss. But Kalento now plays Dr. Boom.
Well, it was green, so no surprise there.
It's generally what you want to do. I agree.
Knife Shatter is a pretty interesting top deck here with all the knives. But then again, how do you deal with those bombs? Like, what's the order? Dr. Boom creates such a complicated board. There isn't Ruben Egg. He can actually play it before attacking the bombs. Maybe he will get lucky. But on the other hand, you sometimes want to get the Ruben Egg against AoE cards, so you want to keep it on board.
Right. You want to play on the 1 in 6 chance, 1 in 7 chance it snipes it and then puts out a 4-4 minion. So I guess you could toss in the spiders, killing off the Argus first. You don't want... Oh! I guess you... Because the problem is you don't want the Knife Jugger to actually die in the collateral, so I think you'd ideally want the most targets out on your side of the field. It, like you said, it's really complicated, man. It's not clear-cut at all. There's a lot of combat math here.
I like attacking with Gangboss first to ensure that it produces a minion and it stays alive, because there was a chance that the Gangboss is getting killed by a bomb, and then it only produced one imp, and here at least you ensure that you're getting some more value. Right. Pretty good bombs for Gaara. The juggler is still alive. Wow, Kalento can actually think about going for face if he wants to. Like, that's so much power. Killing juggler is obviously better, but then that's so much power on board with the Injured Blade Master. Morokoro and Doomguard.
Yeah, I think this was the right call. Just too much pressure onto the board with Knife Juggler out there and minions that can spawn other minions.
Yeah.
And the Doomguard should normally be a pretty good draw. It's just that it gets stopped by Sludge Belcher pretty easily. Looks like he's just going to crash in and kill Dr. Boom, though. And that's going to be his best bet to climb back onto the board. But there is Shadow Word Death. And it leads me to believe that I think Kalento can stabilize here. If he picks up the Pyromancer, for sure he can.
Well, he still has the Fault Steal, so...
All right.
Oh
man, he takes him again. Big minions.
Oh man. Well, he still has to Shadow Word Death this turn, I believe.
Right, but now he's got everything here. Shadow Word Death. Eliminate gang boss or some other minion, play the Light of the Naru and heal up. He's not under significant health pressure, so it's not like he has to worry about just dying.
Yeah, Dr. Boom next turn would be so powerful again. Like, one of the best cards to come back, especially if you have time to play it. And against the zoo, I believe he will have the time. Only facing 4/1/1 minions. Gaara will need to pick up something to activate the Ruben Egg. Basically, this is the board battle. Gaara can't go for face. There's not enough burst in Zoo. Like, Zoo wants to get the minions done. But Kalento still has so many good cards to counter what Zoo is doing. He still has the Holy Nova. He still has this Orcanized Soul Priest, Silk of Healing. He still has second Cabal, I believe. Shadow Madness, he used one. Maybe he's running two.
Oh, well, that Dial of Alpha is a pretty significant deal, too.
It's a great card. He's able to buff all the minions on the board right now.
That's activate such a big deal. Well. Wow. He might consider cashing in the egg so his opponent can't Cabal Shadow Priest, and then killing off the Light Warden, playing the Void Caller between the Nerubian and the Direwolf as well.
I think I like creating a 4-4, especially if my opponent has three cards in hand, and I know that he used Fault Steal. So I would say that it's possible that he got bad cards, and I would assume that there are bad cards, but, well, Dr. Boom is a fantastic card to play here.
Yeah, second boom, and Gaara realizes Kalento thought stole it. Now, of course, he might be able to strike back with some really powerful demons if he draws into it, such as...
Oh, man.
Mal'Ganis.
This is actually so huge. If he's going to implosion that boom and kills it with the Void Caller, he can get Mal'Ganis and buff all the imps. Now the sequencing only. This might be such a powerful turn, and Kalento has nothing to deal with it if Gaara gets what he wants.
67% chance to roll high.
Oh, man. This is so powerful.
Because, like you said, now everything becomes a lot stronger. And you're saying, like, maybe Kalento could stabilize, but Mal'Ganis busts everything up to a 3-3, and those two cards was insane. Kalento's just, like,
just laughing,
shrugging. He's like, well, what am I supposed to do to that? Arcanine, Soul Priest? Oh, man.
There's Sylvanas, but Sylvanas is not doing much here. Shringmeister, not really. I think Kalento might be dead.
What if he kills off Mal'Ganis with the Boombots?
Then that's an option, but I think he needs to attack into Direwolf and then get... Do you just attack Mal'Ganis with both bots?
Listen, the chances are already so low.
Oh man!
You just have to try it.
Well, the dog
he killed off the wolf, but now it's like statistically impossible for you to kill off Mal'Ganis.
Yeah, so Mal'Ganis is going to deal 9 points of damage, and there's 7 left. 4-4 can maybe die, but then the imps are there. Kalento is going to concede. Gaara is going to take the series with Mal'Ganis. I am Mal'Ganis. I am eternal. Gaara takes it.
That's it. 3-2. So Gaara advances, or sorry, he increases. I'm so used to like the game's going to a bracket. Gaara improves his record, and Kalento taps out. What a fun series. And crazy demonstration of why that Void Caller into Mal'Ganis is such a big deal. But more importantly, those imps, it's like Quartermaster with muster for battle, but
that
better.
Oh man, that turn. I just can't believe, like, implosion into Mal'Ganis. You kill the boom, you get the Mal'Ganis for free, just stabilize, do whatever. Whoa, that was the power of Mal'Ganis implosion.
Absolutely. Gaara wins the series 3-2. These guys, it's no secret that they practiced together in the past a lot too, so probably a little bit of a rivalry there when it comes out of practice. But that wraps up our third series of the day, which brings us to our last one. We have Faramir versus Life Coach, I believe. And we're going to be doing that right after we take a break. So don't go anywhere. More action for the NVIDIA Pro-Am continues right after this break.